Okay, so here we are on September 20th. It is right at sunrise here, and it is only 50 degrees Fahrenheit. So once again, I'm out in the bee yard, and I'm inspecting the landing boards to see what they're getting rid of. And wouldn't you know it, the honeybees have cast off again lots of drones. Also, there's a yellowjack in the foreground there. Now it's up to the screen on the right, and it's been stung by bees so much it's just barely quivering there. And here on the left side is a yellow jacket wasp that's chewing away on a carcass which was cast off by the honeybees in this colony, and it looks to have been a drone. So this time of year, the bees are getting rid of drones, but they're also cleaning house constantly, and I have found an increase in the number of varroa destructor bodies that are being cast out, and I've found some on the landing board and in some of the other hives where I have an inserted drone count board. There are bits and pieces of varroa on that, so they're really cleaning house, and sometimes you'll find the varroa concentrated in the cells where these drones are developing. So the drones seem to go first. It also may be due to the cool down that the honeybees are dispensing with their males. They won't need them in winter, but I think it's a little early for that. I think they may be discarding them because the cells may actually have varroa in them. Now these guard bees are defending the colony again. Yellow jackets can fly at much colder temperatures than the bees do, so the bee colony is really just waking up here. And when the yellow jackets land, they try to scoot in on the edges, thinking that that's a good way to get in. But they're met pretty fast by guard bees. So with the colonies as strong as they are, I don't see too many successful runs being made by the yellow jackets. Here's a yellow jacket wasp again working over a drone that's been cast out by the bees. So keep in mind, this is not a bee that was going to make it anyway, but it is kind of pitiful that it's alive while this yellow jacket tries to bite pieces off of it. But it proved unsuccessful at doing that. So yellow jacket mandibles aren't the great cutting tools we might think they are. They're good on soft-bodied insects. Again, he's being run out there in the background by the guard bees. And here's another one trying to chew away again on a developing drone. Now this has been torn apart. See, its head's damaged. Torn apart and pulled out again by the worker bees. And I have seen an increase in the number of varroa destructor bodies that are chewed up and also cast out. The bees completely throw them away, so it's hard to get any kind of count there. In the coming weeks, we are going to do some varroa counts on the bees. We're going to check out the brood frames. But today, we're just looking at the activity on the landing boards, again, when the yellow jackets have that cold weather advantage. Now here's a worker bee tugging away on a drone that is still partially alive, and she's going to fly it away. This is why you don't see piles of dead bees and parts directly in front of the colony, because the workers actually collect them later and fly them away and drop them in the grass, sometimes 100 yards or more. But it's a terrific amount of effort that gets expended here to discard these dead and dying drones. There's a yellow jacket in the background there. It is still alive as it does move gradually, but it appears to have been stung so much that it's shutting down. Now some of the workers that are laying on this landing board in the foreground that are on their backs may have actually been stung by yellow jackets, or they may have been discarded by their fellow bees in that colony. It's hard to tell, since I didn't actually observe what happened to those individuals. But remember, as before, if I didn't come out early like this, I would not see what's going on in the landing boards, and I would not see all the remnants of the things being cast out. This is pretty much a daily routine this time of year. And the hives are full of honey, and that's why they're fanning their wings so much, and they're still dehydrating that. and we're about 80% capped in this colony. There's a yellow jacket putting up a pretty good fight. Another thing I'd like you to know is when the bees are stinging yellow jackets, one of the questions that I often get is, first of all, can bees kill yellow jackets? Usually they just bite and repel them, but if the yellow jacket is tenacious, as this one is, and insists on being in the colony, it's going to receive several stings from these guard bees. They try to get their stingers in between the joints in the abdomen, they sting its head and neck, they sting it around the thorax, and unlike when they sting a person, the hard body of a yellow jacket doesn't hold the stinger. So the bees do have an opportunity to sting it several times and not lose their stingers. Subsequently, these guard bees do not lose their lives when they deliver stings to yellow jackets, so you don't have to feel bad for them. This yellow jacket is trying to extend its own stinger and get one of the honeybees here. You can see that the yellow jacket is really slowing down, otherwise it would fly away by this point. But I think it's been stung enough times that it is really incapable of flight. Now we do know that the yellow jackets, as we observed earlier in this video, are trying to get meat and fly it back. So you know if you're putting out yellow jacket traps this time of year, you definitely want to have some meat resources in it. You'll be attracting these queens. This appears to be a yellow jacket queen. You can correct me if I'm wrong there, but when you see the abdomen and it has those individual black dots that are not connected on the abdomen, generally that is thought to be a queen. I'm sure somebody will clear that up in the comment section. And again, as we predicted, it can't fly. It's ultimately going to die from all the venom that the bees have injected into it. Now this worker has decided that the yellow jacket hasn't had enough yet. You can see the stinger pretty prominent there. It's kind of a futile defensive attempt there on the part of the yellow jacket at this point. And the bees are doing their best to bite it, but remember, bees don't have flesh-cutting mandibles, so it takes a lot of work for them to chew anything off like that. And I've never seen honeybees successfully bite another insect apart like a yellow jacket. But they're just so angry that they use that to drive it off and vent their anger. Biting the toes there, but again, they can't even bite the little toe tips off. They do a good job, as we already know, looking at this landing board, of pulling apart their own developing brood. And it's that soft tissue that these yellow jackets go after. And here's another colony with another tenacious yellow jacket that thought it could get past the guards. Another big mistake on the part of this yellow jacket. Kind of interesting that even with the struggle going on with the yellow jacket that's in there, There are a number of guard bees that have all come out on the landing board and are facing outward just in case other yellow jackets show up. And they do a great job, as shown in this video, of defending their colonies even with the wide open landing boards. In a couple of hours, as the sun comes up, this landing board will be wall-to-wall bees. So it's only during the cold early hours that the yellow jackets really even have a chance to get into that beehive. And of course, by the time I came out here, there were more than enough guards to fend them off, and it's unfortunate for the yellow jackets that do make it in there. They will be quickly overwhelmed by the bees and stung to death and discarded. And again, here are yellow jacket wasps chewing away at another discarded carcass. And here's a drone on its back, flailing its legs. It will be thoroughly ignored by the bees. And it will either die from exposure or starvation. And a worker will come out later and just discard that drone. Here's a yellow jacket that, again, has been stung like some of the others. And is being dragged out by a worker bee. I hope you found this early landing board video interesting and the ability to watch how the bees handle intruders like the yellow jackets. And I hope you'll go out and check your own landing boards right after sunrise, especially in these cold mornings. You'll learn a lot about how they're surviving, what they're throwing away, and how they're faring against raiders like the yellow jacket wasps. Thanks for watching, as always.